On vacation in Orlando last June 12th, 20-year-old Patience Carter on the left, her friend Tierra Parker, and Parker's cousin Akira Murray decided to go out to the Pulse nightclub.
It was so much fun, and we were talking to each other like throughout that night, like, oh, we are definitely coming back here. This is a spot for vacation. We were so set on coming back again. And then the gunshots started and everything.
Shortly after 2 a.m., Omar Mateen entered the club armed with a semi-automatic rifle and a handgun and began firing.
We didn't know if it was gunshots. We didn't know if it was part of the music. All we were doing was feeling the reactions of other people, and everybody was chaotic. And at this point, people are just kind of just running back and forth, not really knowing what to do. I dropped to the floor because I don't know what to do.
Carter, Parker, and Murray ended up hiding together in the club's bathroom. Within minutes, Mateen would follow.
We were like the last few to get into the bathroom stall that we were in. It was like a bigger stall. It was like the handicap stall. And there was already about maybe, 17 to 20 people in that stall already. So we closed the door. And then we just sat down on the floor. So you could still hear people screaming in other parts of the club. And then there was like a period of silence. He walks in, you could hear his footsteps, and then he starts shooting into our bathroom. And his gun got jammed. That's when the shooting stopped.
Carter had been shot in both legs. She laid on the bathroom floor and tried to stay quiet. At 2:35 a.m., she heard Mateen call the police and pledge allegiance to ISIS.
You have to tell America to stop bombing Syria and Iraq. They're killing a lot of innocent people.
That's when it kind of confirmed for me that we weren't going to get out of here because he had a motive. He was there for a reason, and he was trying to prove something. So at that point, I pretty much just gave up.
You thought you were never going to get out of there?
I absolutely thought I was never going to get out. But honestly, I lost hope very, very quickly. So I just started making peace with God.
2.5 hours later, police plowed through the bathroom wall in an armored vehicle. Right before that, Carter says, Mateen came into the bathroom stall where she was hiding.
He has his handgun in his hand. And at this point, my face is turned into the other stall because I really just didn't want to get shot in the face. And I heard him say, hey, you. He shot someone. He shot another person. And then right before the police came in, he shot the person that was directly behind me. That's when the wall came down. So the police came through the wall. All the debris was pretty much all over my face, but I could see through like this one peephole throughout all the debris. I saw like the lights, just the sparks from them exchanging gunfire with one another. So and then there was silence.
Carter spent the next 6 days in an Orlando hospital undergoing surgery on her legs. Her friend Tierra Parker, shot in the stomach, survived. Parker's cousin Akira Murray did not. Carter returned to New York University and has just completed her junior year. She's largely recovered from her physical injuries, but not her emotional scars.
At the beginning of this school year, I was limping to class. You know, it was like I was like literally doing this and getting to class. And now I'm just walking straight. And emotionally, I think it's like every day is a different kind of struggle, I feel like. Some days I'm really up and I'm so happy, life is great, I'm excited about this thing that happened, and then some days I just find myself falling into this like dark place that I don't want to go back to. I was in a really dark place in the hospital, and sometimes I feel myself going back there.
Carter is writing a book about surviving the Pulse nightclub attack. News of other terrorist attacks, like the one after a pop concert in Manchester, England last month, hits her particularly hard.
We're all, you know, at risk of being just like having our lives like devastated at some point. So I just really hope we don't forget about the people and the families that are being affected by these situations that happen, because they're real people.